Hey, it's Fran, again, in my new wood shop. Hey, you've seen a lot more of this space. Those of you who follow me on Twitter have been in the know about the drama of me trying to fix up and move into this new workspace at the same time that my storage space had expired and I had to move stuff all over town for a month. So anyway, but this is it. It's not quite 100% together. It's sort of 80% there, I guess. There's still some details for these workstations, but this is the new space to do woodworking and metalworking and silkscreening and all kinds of stuff that I just can't do in my cramped loft lab that you're used to. So this is a new space. I still have the other lab, but this is the wood shop, so I haven't really got a name for it yet, but it's in the works. I got to come up with a nice name for this new space. So, the Shaper Origin. I was an early backer to Shaper for their Origin project, and I originally saw the prototype being tested by Ben Krasnow at Applied Science, and I'll link that in the description. But that video convinced me right away that I had to have this Shaper. My first off review is it's an amazing tool. I mean, for what it has to do, the accuracy and the usability of it, the ergonomics are all top notch. It's very well built. It has a really nice weight to it, so even with the spindle, you know, vibrating at high speed, you don't really feel it too much in the hands, which was very important to me. That it be not really a vibrating tool because of my nerve issues. But I've spent the last 2 days, I got this on Friday, it's Sunday now, and I spent the last 2 days toying around with this and read every tutorial on the Shaper website and read everything on their blog and everything, so I really wanted to get educated before I even put tool to wood. So my first project, as you saw, is making the little tray. This is an example project they have on the Shaper website, and this was a really fast build. It's a quarter inch plywood, so it's just done in two pieces glued together, although I did embellish it a bit. I put it on the table router and did the edging and sort of made it nice and kind of finished, you know. But it was just an interesting project to start to get used to the ins and outs of the Shaper. Now I did have a couple of unforeseen things. I didn't lay out enough tape, so at one point the Shaper couldn't see enough alignment tape to continue, and I had to shut it down, add some tape, and I had to update the image of the workspace and take another sample of that workspace and then go back and continue again so that I could actually work a little further away from where I thought I'd be working to make this project. But that was one interesting thing. Also, the other thing I found is if you're working in the virtual space that is created in the augmented reality of the Origin, you can cut in any orientation. So if you run out of reference tiles, or whatever they're going to be called, those little markers, I like tiles, I guess is a cool word, but those, if it runs out of tiles or markers to see, I found you can rotate it slightly. You can still push it forward, but turn it at an angle, and it can see more markers over here, and it'll get the good indicator for being on alignment, and you can continue to go around a corner. I also really like the fact that when you're moving on the auto mode, if you get to a corner, you can stop and then put the pathway in the circle, hit the button for auto, and it will, even though you stop moving the Shaper, hit the button, it'll actually move the tool and do that little intricate cut, and it allows you to do a little more detail around corners and such thing you would if you were trying to hand maneuver it around. I did this one really quick. I mean, if I wanted to get the interiors like really high tolerance, I should have done it the way they recommend, which is you rough it out first by programming the lines to be a little under, and then you rough it out, and then you set it to be on the line, and then do a second pass, finish pass, and get the nice high tolerance cuts, which I definitely will be experimenting with as I get deeper into this. So I'm a huge fan of the Origin. I wanted to support Shaper's project because I saw the possibilities in this, not just what it could do in the prototype stage. I saw that with updating the firmware of a tool like this, that the possibilities of the kinds of cuts and stuff you can do, I know that that's really where the future of this tool is. All that being said, a couple of pet peeves. It could be a generational thing, the difference between the age of the designers for a tool like this and someone who's been using tools like myself for decades. But number one pet peeve with the Origin is there's no off switch. You can't turn it off. Now, I've had the Origin for 2 days, so I might be missing it somewhere, that there's some like big red switch on it somewhere that actually turns it off. But there isn't. They went through great lengths to make the turning off the spindle redundant. You've got an on-off switch here on the spindle, plus a little cord attachment. You can actually detach it so you can make it double safe. And they tell you often in the tutorials to unplug the spindle when you're doing testing and stuff, doing test cuts and stuff. And you also have to disconnect to take the spindle out to change the bit. But you can't turn off the Origin. The computer and everything, the lights and the cameras, you know, there's lights in the back, there's sets of cameras. Everything stays powered up all the time as long as it's plugged in. There is no standby mode that I can find. I even went so far as to actually do search on Google and on the Shaper website looking for anything on power up, down, power switch, but there's not even a reference to it. And strangely, in all of the how-tos and tutorials, they never once even mention that you can't turn it off, or that to turn it on, you plug it in. It's not even mentioned. It's kind of a weird thing. I don't know if they designed it this way intentionally for liability reasons, but for someone like myself, it's kind of distressing to have a power tool that doesn't have an off switch, or an appliance that doesn't have an off switch. It's like you wouldn't buy a car that you couldn't turn off, and you wouldn't buy a toaster that didn't have an off switch. It's like, how's the toaster work? Oh, you plug it in, you're toasting. Well, how do I stop the toaster? Oh, you gotta unplug it. That's sort of what the Origin is. And when they make the Mark II of this, I'd really like to see a physical on-off switch, you know, on the side here or something, something to turn it off, the power, or if not that, something in the firmware so that you can have a virtual standby or hibernation state where you can just pause your project and put it to sleep, tell it, you know, hey, you know, I want to take a break, you know, put it on pause and hibernate it and leave the tool where it is. They could come back later, turn it on, take it out of hibernation, and it's right there, not only in the same place, but in the same place of the project that you're doing. That would be helpful. I'd also find that when I had to make that change by adding some more tiles and re-sampling the workspace, I couldn't go back to my project to where I was. When I got back to the project, it had forgotten or erased the project, all the routing and cutting that I had already done, and I sort of just had to start on it fresh with the idea of where I started. Another pet peeve that I have about the Origin in the current state is that there's no file management. Whenever you scan a workspace, it saves it. And you can go into the directory and you can see all the saved workspaces, but you can't delete any of them. And you can't, there are just no options to really have any kind of file management. I really would like to see that in a future firmware upgrade, because I'm not going to want to store every single scanned workspace that I'm ever going to use, and I don't need to keep them after I've done the project. It's useless, so I'd really like to be able to get in there and have more control over file management in future firmware upgrades. So yeah, it's I'm confident that they're going to have lots of updates and they're going to make the applications for this expand greatly. One of the things I'd like to see in future firmware updates is the ability to use different bits, because I've got hundreds, probably literally hundreds of router bits, And it would be nice to be able to use this for doing dovetail joints and such. You know, you got the dovetail bit, and it, I can certainly see why, you know, if you have the correct 90 degree setup, that you could program, or have, if you had the ability to program Origin to accept to do a dovetail joint, it would even be cool to have the intelligence with the camera, like show the Origin camera a bit, like I have this dovetail bit, and to be able to program the Origin to do a dovetail, it would be nice to be able to show this to the camera and you know, give it some different views, and then perhaps then tell the Origin the width of the bit at the maximum size and the length of the bit, and give it its, you know, give it the dimensions and let it extrapolate the tool, and then use it. I mean, there'd have to be a way to do that, especially with you know, bits that can go back a ways. Some of these bits I have are like 30 years old, so I doubt they'd be in a catalog anywhere. Okay. Plug it in. Okay. Camera's on, the lights are on. It's got these pretty good powerful lights in the back, and no tape found. Okay. Yeah, well, it's not gonna cooperate with me because it's looking for tape. Take some tape from the other project. There we go. So the tape is really interesting. It's about 12, they sell it, it's about 12 cents a foot. And originally I thought, well, if the tape is going to be really expensive, you know, it might be a way to, like, you know, copy the tape and, like, make your own, like, template. There might be a way to do that, but I thought, too, that the indicators seem to be very unique. I thought that each roll would be the same, but they're not. They actually have a serial number on the roll, and they don't start out with the same coated tile. It's there's definitely, I don't know if they're random or if they have, you know, a certain limited number of sets of these, or when they repeat or if they repeat. That's definitely a proprietary thing. I'm going to scan. Start scan. And you can see here, I'm scanning the workspace, and it's looking for all the tiles it can find. Now, when I've got them all in there, I'll hit the finish button. Now it's doing all the calculations to create the real virtual workspace. Lost my light. I haven't got all the lighting set up in here. I have lights on this side and on that side. And the sun's gone down, so I lost the daylight, so it's getting a little dark in here. But I'm going to wrap it up by saying that the reason that I got the shaper wasn't for the cool little CNC type projects like this necessarily, although this is pretty cool. It was because of the ability to scan line drawings. And this is the thing that I really want to get into with the Origin. It's the ability to use the camera to directly scan pencil and pen drawings on paper and then do a cut to scale right in the lines. So I still do a lot of my design work pencil and paper at the drafting table, and now with the Origin, theoretically, I could draft parts to scale, actual size, pen on paper, bring it in, scan that in, and then cut out a part exactly that size and shape. So that's going to be the next level of my experimentation with the Origin. If that really works out to be something that's really doable, then that's going to be like a dream come true for me, to be able to go right from paper to milling without actually even using CAD. This is an autonomous machine, and you can really use it without having to go with a vector file. You don't have to design in vector files. You can, theoretically, design shapes on paper, scan it in, use the pen feature, you know, put it on a grid, you know, perhaps you, I don't know if you can scale, but I have to look into that. But, you know, that's the next step for me here in the wood shop. So, yeah, gotta turn this off. The only way you can turn it off is to unplug it. So, come on. There you go. It's not very elegant. I really would like an on-off switch on this thing. So, yeah, Shaper Origin, mythological. First ones to be made, and looking forward to really expanding the capabilities of this, really kind of finding out how accurate it is in different materials and such, and getting used to the ins and outs of the mighty Shaper Origin. There you go. I'm Fran, in the dark now, but I will get some more lighting in here. It's gotta finish up the wood shop, but it's coming along just fine. So I'll see you soon at the shop. Bye.